next time, the protest of January 15, 1990. The blockade next time will stand up like a resolute crane's neck, lowering its steel beak to pick sin from the festering craw of the people's pains. It will not pass, cast pace, as waste through the bowels of ordinary men. 444, these are extraordinary times. Calling up to service each of us beyond the self, to be about our nation's business. The blockade to come will stand up as a throne of stone, a throw of people resolved to last for 40 days and 40 nights as rain and sun wash our furrowed brow and working hands as we labor in the streets to sweat forth green shoots from which will flower in our midst the new lawgivers of just statutes of consensus gatherings to take us winged beyond the realm of burden to the promised sweet land, the semantic of our waking dreams. The blockade next time will not be betrayed in a party where the music played is not for the dragon to dance, and the song and dirges of death are chanted to crush the eggs and dragon spawn of our freedom bound sojourn. So here now of the blockade to come that will not fall down from hush mouth, bush mouth, trush mouth, bus up mouth to shush, but will gather from descent its difference, from the pyre its phoenix future. The blockade next time will not be abandoned, emasculated of its mandate. Tractors will be turned into plowshares of living people who will each deposit I and I only life as investment and dowry, as inheritance and property, as the collateral of forwardness, as the cash of change. And next time you will be the trumpeting horn hollering in the 40 morning, and the gales will wail and wail from border to border, and you self will be the writing on the wall that ruler, new settler, and soldier will come to stalk, to wipe out like chalk. So you better make up your mind to change things now, or come in a time, stressed bare, dressed as you are, but come you must, come with the armor of truth committed to life. Come with the receipts of the ages, we see wet as cow dung, and let us plow vaults of justice, roots steeped into this land to reclaim this claim. This blood earth mangrove abode, this abide of power, risen of plunged sea, rich salt and sanctified flesh, from where wealth worked will always arise. We are already standing on the grounds where we are bound to perish, or mold this nation in our very own image. For freedom, not paid for, is forfeit.